Hello and welcome everyone. This is Golden Lion Tarot, here to bring you a timeless pick a card tarot reading. Today our subject is what magical blessing awaits you. All right, so we've got three different piles topped with these lovely star drawings from one of my children to help assist with this reading. And we've got three crystals topping them, aligning with the piles, helping you to better pick which pile is for you. All right, pile one, we've got this lovely little smooth tumbled selenite palm stone. May the selenite help clear through fog and straight the truth and to all that you need to align with your higher self and higher knowings. All right, then for pile two, we've got this lovely tumbled fire agate. I ask this agate to assist you with completing projects that are important and keeping the fires burning, the passion alive in your life. And pile three, we've got this quartz with a black tourmaline throughout it. So I ask this gorgeous round crystal to help purify, detoxify your life in a healthy, bountiful, beautiful way. All right, so take all the time that you need to align yourself with these piles and to feel into which pile is calling you. Welcome to your reading, pile number one. You chose this lovely, flashy selenite. Great for clearing and cleansing the smoke, the fog, out of your brain, and keeping a room in a high vibration. These stones are great for just like keeping, they're also good for keeping all your other stones in a healthy state. So if you feel that, because crystals pick up on other people's energy, and if somebody else was holding your crystal or around your crystal too much, your crystal could pick up on a negative energy and then amplify it. So if you hold this type of crystal next to it, they help to keep all of your crystals clear, as well as your brain and your energy and just like the overall energy of the room. So I ask this crystal to do all of these things for you. All right. So what magical blessing awaits you, pile one? I've pulled some cards, got this lovely star topping it to help get that energy rolling and make you feel like a star throughout this reading. Okay, so let me put these back in order. So what magical blessing is awaiting you, my friend? First out, we've got Judgment, number 20 in the tarot deck. So we've got, this may be the end. You might be getting close to ending a chapter in your life. You may be going through some sort of a transformation at this time. Wow, the Queen of Swords, nice. Got the Queen of Swords coming through with mental clarity. Then we've got number eight, trapped in fear. That's a lot of transformational energy. So the judgment and the number eight are all about cycles ending and new ones beginning. The infinity sign, the number eight, is all relative to transformation and aligning to a higher purpose after completing a cycle. So you could be getting near to the end of a specific cycle. That's really huge, and that would be an amazing, beautiful blessing. Then we've got the air element. Number 28. All right, so I feel like there's a lot of air energy already presenting itself in your reading. We've got the Queen of Swords presenting air, and we also have the air element sign. So could be that you are, some of you might be in school right now, or there's a lot of new information that has come into your life recently, and it's been making quite a few changes, and it may have like mowed over some of your old belief systems, activating new ones in like a real like a paramount way, so that to the point that maybe your viewpoint has changed over the years. And we've got the four of diamonds. So some of you may have certain pets that you are like almost communicating with. I'm getting the sense that some of you are like having an interaction with a sort, with an animal, with, you may be anticipating its needs at this time, or having like a telepathic communication system with this animal. Maybe you all of a sudden realize you know what that animal's thinking, and this is spirit wanting to like correlate that, yes, you were right. Like this is almost like spirit saying it wasn't in your imagination. Yes, you were communicating with this animal being. Okay, then we've got heart with a key. Welcoming love, meeting the one, open your heart, getting together, and perfect. Wow, so nice. Okay, so through this knowledge that you're I keep getting the sense that there's like a whole huge amount of knowledge that just came like hurling itself through into your life. Maybe it has done so in a way that that could have almost like given you a few setbacks, but just because it's giving you some sort of a setback, it does not mean that it's in all actuality sending you back. It's only like, it's not even like spiritually like a detour. It's almost like a longer way to get to a destination. You kind of feel like that may be happening, but that's not what the arrangement is of this information. That's not what this information is doing to you. It just feels like that. All right, and we've got clarity, truth, intentions, honesty. Yeah, so this information is, I feel like for you, your magical blessing that's awaiting you is like this beautiful information that's presenting itself for you. Okay, I know you're like, well, I wanted the money, I wanted this, I wanted that, I get that. But this is what's going to lead you to that. So this information is information that is not going to just go away. This information is here because it is part of your plan. It's part of the ultimate plan. I see that there's limitations and fears around this. And that's only because you haven't gotten to the point where you've realized that this information is truly beneficial to you in your life at this time. You will get to that point. There will be a reckoning, a moment where everything levels out and you emerge and realize that this was all in divine, divine, beautiful alignment. So let's see. Let's just get some more clarity, Spirit. Let's get some clarity on this judgment card. Oh my goodness, you've got more Swords energy, more Swords energy. You've got the Ace of Truth. Here we are. So you may be judging people differently than you ever have before. You may find out that the harsh judgments that you passed onto others like so long ago are no longer valid. And for a lot of you, you're going to be realizing that some of those harsh judgments that you did once possess were only there because maybe it was handed down to you. It was never like a truth that was born within your soul. Okay. So knowledge is like this. We have a piece of knowledge, then we share it with others, and then others, you know, share it with another, and we hold on to the knowledge as fact until a new truth comes along and a paradigm shift may occur, and you need a new concept because you're becoming a new person. And some of these beliefs are falling away. And some of these beliefs, you're realizing, weren't ever true in the first place. And for some of you, you'll feel that they were true, but they're not valid for this point in your life. And all of these new truths are what's going to be prompting your happiness going forward. Okay, let's get another card on the Queen of Swords spirit. Okay, so I see some of you are up at night. Some of you, like, when it's time to go to sleep or when you get alone, that's when, like, the fear set in, the limiting belief systems. This is spirit trying to, your spirit guides trying to show you what you still have inside of you that needs purification. These thoughts that are reoccurring within your mind space are not there to hurt you. They're not there to show you that you're not good enough. They're not there to show you that there's nothing but doom or gloom ahead of you. They're simply there because spirit's trying to show you what is no longer going to be serving you in your future. So your eyes are being opened. I see like Libra at its finest in this card. I also see the all-seeing eye. So your eyes opening, your mind is opening. I see the motions of the months. You're seeing like your belief systems may be changing monthly. But then there's those few beliefs that you may hold on to that create a bit of disillusionment, and they feel uncomfortable. But you have this armor on. This woman is smart. She shields herself from like pillagers or anyone that's going to hurt her. But she keeps her heart open. She's ready to learn from her elders or even from a child. She's armored, but her heart is open, ready to learn. This is you. This is how spirit's presenting you right now. Like this beautiful person that's shielded, but has this wide open heart. But is also suffering a bit because your magical blessings is knowledge, is your mind, is the way that you present, is information. It's the way the information comes to you and the way that you release information. There's like a really beautiful, magical gift in that for you. So let's see what else we've got on this Trapped in Fear card. The Tower. Oh my goodness, so beautiful. And so no wonder this is in your reading. So these trapped in fear notions that run through your head at the most unopportune time are crumbling. It may feel like they are not. It may feel like there's times that they feel so overpowering to any other bit of information that you possess that it totally encompasses your ability to move freely as a beautiful human on this earth. But my friend, you have the Tower card, so that shows me that at some point this person is not even going to be present in your life anymore. So your beliefs are changing, and along with those beliefs, this trapped in fear situation is going to be falling down, caving in, and vanishing. Okay, so what can you do to get there? I would like some more information on that, spirit. Okay, so spirit wants you to lay down some of it. First of all, it looks like you may have too many things going on in your life. You could possess multiple jobs. I know a lot of us have to pay the bills. But spirit would like to find you to find, and maybe if that's not your case, then you just have like a lot of obligations or people that depend on you, or you could be putting your energy into multiple avenues. And spirit would just like you to take a moment to find out what are the most important avenues for you to put your energy into, and see if there may be an opportunity for you to just like take one of the things that you are doing that you don't believe is healthy for you. Okay, that's the key point. See if you can get rid of the one thing that doesn't seem healthy for you. Maybe it's the way you talk to yourself. Because talking and knowledge and wisdom is what's the focus of your reading. That's where your blessings are coming from. That's what's leading you to your happiness. So if you're talking to yourself in a negative way, then you're not going to be able to reach this point of, you're gonna get there no matter what I say, or no matter what tarot reading you listen to, or no matter what book you read or who you hang out with. You will get to your judgment moment, to your brand new clarity, to the point that your mind is free of all of these impure. It's almost like your mind sometimes gives you setbacks. You will get there to the point of that not happening no matter what you do. It's just that if you take some advice, there's going to be points in your life where like somebody says something, because this is all about the air element, which is speaking, knowledge, wisdom, communications. You're gonna get communication that really speaks to your heart, and you're just gonna like apply that bit of advice to your life, and then all of a sudden it's just going to change. Now, is it going to happen overnight? I don't see that. I'm not saying that. Everybody's at different stages of this also, but you do hold the key to this unraveling. Right. I'm getting another message on this animal. So for some of you, you may have a dog or a cat, or you have some sort of an animal that's been around your house that was locked in a box. So maybe you took your dog to the vet, maybe you took your cat to the vet, or you trapped an animal outside. This animal kind of was like going spastic in its head. It felt like it was trapped, like there was no way out, like this energy, trapped in fear, trapped in one of those boxes. Well, it didn't notice that it was on its way to the vet to get help. Didn't know that soon it was going to be free in a new environment that was going to be a lot healthier and happier. Okay, so it fed off of its negative emotions and worried itself more than it needed to. And by the time the whole scenario was over and it got its shots, or it was released into the wilderness, or whatever the beautiful thing was that was happening to them, I see this animal kind of just like beat up a little bit from worry. But it gets to that point, to the freedom moment, to the point where it might be laying in the corner because it just got neutered or fixed, and it's able to like look back and just like feel, oh, it was all for my own good. I feel like that's like symbolic for something that's going on in your life right now. It could be that sometimes when you're trapped in these fears, you're not able to fully focus on what the end game is here. Because there is an end game. And the end game is being this wise woman or man or whatever your goal is to become. Okay, so let's grab a card on this heart with a key spirit. Oh my goodness, look at that. So this knowledge is bringing you to love, guys and girls and everyone. Oh my goodness. So this, okay. So you are like a truth seeker, a knowledge hunter, and this wisdom that just, it's like when you hear wisdom, knowledge, truth, maybe from a tarot reading, maybe from the internet, maybe from a friend, maybe from someone you don't know, but it's just like someone walking by, you hear something. That knowledge, it's like you take it to heart, and that it just seeds, it's like the beginning, it's a fire starter, and it the embers get like blown on and they spark, and then this fire begins to rage, and it just glows, and all of that wisdom, all of that communication, all of that knowledge is when your heart opens the most. And through all that knowledge, you're going to be finding like a divine partner. Someone that is on the same journey you are on. Someone that feels so similar to the way that you have felt. Someone that you're going to be able to share such like intimate truths and intimate challenges and like blissful times. And you're going to be so thankful that you did not bypass all of this time, all of these fears, all of this trapped energy, so that when you're able to share it all with this person, you feel such a like sense of fulfillment. It's almost like this person had very similar limitations and fears and a lot of like the same triggers. It's like you guys have like similar triggers, disharmony, and it's how you're able to bond. And but it's going to be in a place of love, not in a place of disharmony, not in a place of limiting belief systems. It's going to be in a space of openness and creativity and clarity. So if you're having lack of ambition at time is at now, that's because you're not quite qualified for this moment, but this moment is in the cards. This moment is the future. Sometimes we have to unravel a little bit of knowledge here and there because it's not when the best, it was given to us out of a time of darkness, you know, like maybe you had like a really oppressive upbringing, or like your family were churchgoers and they told you you had to live like this and this way was the right way, and none of the other ways was the right way. And that, and maybe you don't believe that to this day, but there's some sort of a seed that got sprouted within you, and it's just like it might be stopping you from allowing yourself to really focus on the fact that you do have fears and that you do have some conflicting sadness, depression, or grief or frustrations, something that's disabling you from the forward movement of this wisdom. And it's okay. It's just, that's fine, because you're growing. This is where your blessing is. So out of the hardest things that we go through, our biggest blessings come from, right? That is what's going on here. So if you feel weak, or if you feel like you're failing somewhere, just know that that is where this wisdom is going to be going to and breaking it up, and someday you'll be flourishing from it. Okay, so if things feel a little bit chaotic now, clarity is coming. All right, just hang in there. Don't try to ignore the fact that you feel uncomfortable. It's okay to feel uncomfortable. It's okay to notice that you feel uncomfortable, because you can't just like wish something away, right? We've all tried that. It doesn't really work. You gotta kind of like accept the fact that you feel a little bit crummy toward the situation in order for it to change. Right. I also see some of you getting some clarity through looking at old pictures. It's going to bring back a feeling, an old feeling that there was a little bit of wisdom or truth that set you back, or you're not sure. It wasn't, there's something about a picture, or you looking at pictures and it opening up a place for you to heal from, or a place for you to understand whatever was going on at that time better. And for others of you, you might want to take a picture of something that you're not sure about. Take a picture of it so that you might be able to get a different point of view, looking at it from another lens, another vantage point. Okay, so let's get one final card for you. Pile one. My super attractor power comes from how I feel, how my faith in love and the joy I put out. There we go again about how you feel. It's okay to feel a little bit crummy about something, because whatever feels fearful, that's where you're going to be gaining a blessing. Okay? Because you are like the master of knowledge. You are the master of understanding something. You will be mastering the wisdom within that. So my super attractor power comes from how I feel, my faith in love, and the joy I put out. My super attractor power comes from how I feel, my faith in love, and the joy that I put out. Very beautiful. All right, so if this reading resonated for you, please leave me a like. Please subscribe to this channel. Please let me know down in the comment section if you enjoyed this. And also, if you're able to give a monetary donation to me at this time, something to help me to keep this channel going, this would be a really, really great help to both me and my family. Okay, so until there's also a little link at the bottom for PayPal if you're able to assist with that. Okay, thank you guys, and I will see you the next time. Hello and welcome, friends. So you chose pile number two, and we are asking Spirit what magical blessing awaits you. We've got this lovely fire agate for you, helping to assist you with your passion projects and helping you to keep a fiery, childlike attitude so that you can enjoy your life. All right, I've asked this crystal to do all of that for you throughout this reading. Okay, so what awaits you? What magical blessing is awaiting you, pile number two? All right, so we've got, oh wow, you've got Jupiter, the wheel of a fortune. Ding, 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 ding. All the bells and the charms and the songs are playing for you, because you just got like one of the luckiest cards in the whole deck. So, wow, it's almost like jackpot. You won something beautiful. Nice. I mean, you can't beat getting the Wheel of Fortune through when you're asking what magical blessing is awaiting you. So rest be assured, okay, this lifetime has something beautiful in store for you. Okay, something that's going to be affecting your family, your foundational, it's like your stability, your foundation. You're going to have achievements that are going to be affecting your stability. Patience and planning, my friends. Patience and planning. Okay, all good things come to those that relax and don't count the minutes when they're waiting. Okay, we've got the moon card. So you could be staying up at night working on things. You could be You could be tired of TV. I'm feeling for some of you, you could have like watched all the shows that you like, and now there isn't your usual like routine at night is wanting to change up. Something about your routine at night is wanting to change. When the moon's out, your routine, something to change. Maybe it's time for you to start meditating before you fall asleep. For others of you, it may be time to start crafting something while you're watching TV, or turn the TV off altogether and find another form of entertainment. For everyone, it's going to be a little bit different. Something about your nightly routine changing up. So, what can you do to just like integrate some little change into your nightly routine? Whatever it is that's been on your brain, or if it hasn't come to you yet, it's gonna come to you very soon. All right. Wow, you got lightning. Okay, courage, beautiful. So, whew, yes, I mean, you've got luck, you've got courage, you've got yellow springing forth from everywhere. So you're gonna be in a place of power. You're gonna be in a place of making other people's life stable. You're gonna have so much stability that you're going to be able to help other people's life feel stable. Really lovely. Okay, we've got the 10 of diamonds. So you've been working hard on something, or you have worked hard in this lifetime, or your work is not going to go unnoticed. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Look at that. You've got lightning twice. That's crazy. Wow. I've only like, I don't think I've ever pulled either of these cards on my tarot channel, and you got both of them. Whoa, I'm like blown away right now. Okay, so sudden change, shocking news, surprise, epiphanies, upheaval, transformation. Okay, so you've got transformation in the cards. You also have sudden changes and like, wow, you're gonna have a completely different. It's almost as if you are gonna have like two different lifetimes. Like your life was like, maybe you've changed your career path a few times, or you're going to be, because you've got change in the cards. All right, last card, we've got ecstasy, chasing thrills, excitement, good times. So, dear pile two, I see you chasing your dreams. At some point, you're gonna realize, if you haven't already, what it is that you truly are passionate about. What it is in this lifetime that really gets your happiness stirring, your excitement up, like your prana glowing. So, I definitely see some change in the cards, but it's going to be all for the happiness of your ecstasy, chasing your happiness. I see you chasing your set happiness, feeling excited about life. Knowing that life is my cat's trying to get up here into he's not gonna find a happy spot because I have cards all over on the side of this. Oh, you're gonna try to get up there, are you? Okay, well, you're not gonna stay too long, mister. My cat's named Jupiter. No wonder he had to come up here. Say hi, Jupes. Come over here. Come here, Jupiter. Jupiter. Okay, I'll just show you how handsome he is. Maybe. Say hi, Jupes. There's Jupiter coming. Sorry, I just had to show you him. That's my kitty that has to come see you because his name's in the card too. So he's giving you a little extra good luck toward your dreams and toward all that you are wanting to create in this lifetime. Come here, mister. I knew there was not going to be enough room for you. All right. So that's from the last reading, my bad. So what is it that stirs your heart, that stirs your your solar plexus, what makes you feel like you are powerful, what makes you feel like proclaiming that you are here on this earth and you are ready to be of service to both yourself, to humanity, because I see you serving other people. If you don't know what that is right now, don't worry. I don't even need to pull clarifiers for you, but I will, because this, like, I have such an excitement just stirring inside my belly. Okay, so let's pull a card for the Wheel of Fortune. So you may be holding on to your money right now. You may be like, I don't have that money. I don't know what you're talking about. Like, the money's not there. I'm pinching pennies. I don't know how to, like, pay my bills after, like, it's almost like some of you might be living paycheck to paycheck right now. I get that. I get that. I do. But that doesn't necessarily mean that's what your future is. Because you have magical blessings awaiting you of stability. And we need money in order to have stability. And if you have an abundance of money and you're hoarding it, ask yourself why. Ask yourself why. What could you use it? How could you use your money to make your life better, or the people you love's life better, or humanity's life better? Because for everybody, we get a sense of well-being from where we put our money shows who is important to us. And where we put our money shows what we're willing to invest into, what we believe is worth our time, worth our attention. So if you invest your money into something, then spirit is going to acknowledge that, and then spirit will use that in order to give back to you. I see that happening, like you investing money into something and then it just outpouring like mountainous blessings to you. I'm not saying to just go invest your money without knowing that that's where you want to invest your money. But if you find that somewhere inside of you just really lights you up, if it's something that just feels so, like, if it makes you sizzle and fizzle inside and something like that, then yes, that's a damn good sign the spirit's telling you this is what's gonna make you happy. Okay, so I don't know what that thing is for you. It may involve moving for some of you. It may involve the people in your family. I'm seeing, or like, extended family members, or, okay, we've got the Three of Wands. So for some of you, you're going to be moving in the future. Your magical blessing is going to involve you traveling to another place and having different atmosphere around you. For others of you, it's going to involve you taking short trips within your community. Could be whatever the next season is coming up, you're going to start feeling some sort of a, like, for me, it's winter. For you, it might be spring coming. Whatever the next season's coming up, I feel like you're going to start seeing, if you haven't already, something in which lightens you up, which shows you the way, which makes you sizzle and fizzle inside. All right, so let's see something on this foundation, actually. Let's go with another deck, Spirit. Show me more about this foundation and achievement card, Spirit. Oh wow, so pleasure. Some of you, it's gonna help bring in your mate, your partner in life. It's gonna be connected to that. So whatever it is that you, it's like your passion project is gonna be intertwined with a love. And either way, if you already have the love of your life, then it's gonna be intertwined with somebody that you love and care about, or something. Most definitely, it's something that gives you passionate feelings, not necessarily romantic passion, but a passion, beautiful, beautiful passion inside. It's all over the place. Let's see. People seem to act like there's simply not enough time in our world too, I'm noticing. Like a lot of people say, oh, there just isn't enough time in the day. But so maybe you're gonna say something like, there just isn't enough time in the day for me to start anew, a brand new risk. I'm taking a risk. Well, if you're gonna surrender to defeat in that way, then maybe you won't have time. But if you say, this is important to me, I'm gonna find a way, right? Then that's you announcing what's in what you are. And then spirit will open up the channel. Your perimeters will widen. Lightning will strike. Ideas will flow if you make that important. If you surrender to defeat, then no, by all means, that won't open up for you. But I don't see you doing that. I do see maybe some unexpected storms or delays on their way. That could happen because when you have that much. Electricity, thunderstorms are bound to happen at times. So let's get another card on that. Okay, so you might have to juggle something right now. Maybe you're not allowed to just go full force into your, you're like, great, this sounds great, but I just, I really don't have the time of day. Okay, I get it. Stop saying that, first of all. Maybe. That's true, but you don't have to say it. Maybe just you can say something like, well, I don't know how I could juggle that into my life right now. And I would like to find the flow to be on that timeline. So, and in the meantime, we've got something about night to work with. Night to work your passion into something, the tiniest seed. Look at that. You've got King of Pentacles, you've got so much stability in this reading that I'm gonna say, dear soul, that you have magical blessings just all around you, waiting for you to acknowledge. So, you've got the King of Pentacles, you're gonna have the financial, you have finances around you, you have wealth within you have stability within you. It's up to you to open that portal up to allow it to flow in. More abundantly. More abundantly. Some of you are going to travel a bit, could be in your car a bit more than you have been. Others of you are working hard and finding a way to open up your night to integrate this energy. But overall, you've got ecstasy, chasing thrills, excitement, good time. Who doesn't want to be dancing through life? Got ecstasy coming because you're following what is exciting to you. You're going to feel like you're dancing, like you're on air. Yep, there could be a couple casualties. We all run into barriers, but that doesn't mean that you're not ultimately getting to this Wheel of Fortune. So allow yourself some time to get lost in the sauce of being happy. Ride the wave of happiness. If somebody makes you feel happy, then see what it is about that person that makes you feel happy. What is their characteristic that appeals to you? And see if you can integrate it into your life. Because spirit's trying to show you the signs. There's lightning bolts all around you. Spirit's showing you signs of what your ecstasy entails, and it's coming. It's coming. Okay, let's grab one more card For you, pile two. Actually, I want to grab two more cards. Give me one more card around this working hard card spirit. Ah, Ace of Cups. Okay, so you are finding, you're going to find emotional fulfillment through some sort of work. Imagine that. Emotional fulfillment through work. That's what dreams are made of, my friend. Okay. I can do less and attract more. That's what we were talking about, right? So if you feel that you're overloaded with something, you're juggling something, or if you're hoarding, okay, know that if you get rid of something, more will come in. All right. So if this reading made sense to you, please leave me a like. Please subscribe to my channel. This way I can continue syncing myself to your energies and relating more messages. And also, if any of you are able to donate to my work to help me and my family at this time and to assist me with the continuation of these readings, I would greatly, greatly appreciate this. There is a link to use PayPal below in the description if you're able. If that brings love in your heart, then you will know that it is the right thing that will work for you. Okay? I send you all so much love, so many blessings as you continue navigating throughout your day and throughout your lives. All right, I'll meet you in the next reading. Take care. Hello and welcome, Pile 3. This is your reading. Now we are discussing what magical blessing awaits you. And you chose this quartz crystal with black tourmaline running throughout it. And this crystal is good for purifying, detoxifying. It could be your mind, body, or your life circumstances. So I asked this crystal to do just that for you, Pile 3. All right. So what magical blessing awaits you? Okay, first card out, we've got the Ace of Coins. Nice. So a new stable, grounded endeavor. Beautiful. Oh, wow. Another ace. So Ace of Pentacles. Whoa. Okay. So you really have a new stable endeavor awaiting you. Beautiful. Got double eight. That's two times Ace of Coins. Then we've got, oh my gosh. All right, another ace. So triple aces for you. Looks like you've got a really good hand here. Okay, so the Ace of Swords. Wow, triple aces. That's my first time getting triple aces. That's exciting for you. Okay, so we've got brand new endeavors happening. We've got creative stability happening. We've got new knowledge being formulated, your mind opening, your mind understanding a new concept and putting it into a stable, grounded, planted, rooted system. Then we've got psychic. Nice. So you are receiving psychic acknowledgement right now. Your psyche is opening up. Your psyche is becoming more attuned, more open, more aware. We've got Luna. We've got the moon. Wow, and you got the star. Okay, so I feel like your astrology symbolism is playing in your life right now, or wants to play a little bit more in your life right now, wants to bless you in some way. Mirror, nice. Okay. Mirroring each other. So you could be mirroring someone. You could be caring a lot about your self-image right now. You may have relationships that reflect wounds, and you may be doing a lot of introspection at this time. Okay, so I'm seeing you definitely have a beautiful beginning coming in, and I feel like it's all circulating. This blessing is going to be circulating your body. I see cells, I see body, I see DNA change, I see some upgrade, some big, beautiful, strong body cell regenerative. Cell regeneration, something beautiful within your body is maybe you haven't had a lot of energy lately and your body is under repair and your DNA is activating, changing to some degree, and you are becoming more rooted through this situation. But you may have looked in the mirror a few times and haven't been nice to your body. Spirit doesn't like that. Okay. So let's see. We've got the Eight of Pentacles. So a lot of you are working on your body, or you're going to be, because this is where your beautiful magical blessing awaits you. You've got a beautiful magical blessing awaiting you through your beautiful body. So I see someone strong, someone bodybuilding, or a body that's about to feel happier in some way. You could have been like in a very unfulfilling place with your body, where you didn't love, you didn't respect your body in the way that spirit would like you to. And now you're if you're not right now, you're going to be like generating this brand new outlook on how beautiful and how fortunate you are to own this body and what you can do to help stabilize it and help make it feel grounded and more secure in this life, and able to like house your soul. See, the Ace of Swords, your body is like a system, just like I'm seeing it, just like in here. Your body's a system, all right? Just like all the tangible things here on Earth are systems. Able to be manipulated. So if you believe you will always be overweight, then you will be overweight. If you believe your body's falling apart, you know the rest. If you believe your body has the ability to function in a more efficient way, then your body will respond. I see you like making new neural pathways in your brain for the upgrading of the way you view your beautiful soul holder, your beautiful person holder. I don't know what you want to call your body, but you need to get a new word for it. Like, you need to start, like, it would be great if you could come up with a new name for your body, one that you just like totally respect. Ah, your name. Your name. And if you want to use a different name, that's great too. But you need to have some sort of a name for your body, for your vehicle, so that you have ultimate respect for it. Instead of like being in this gray zone where you don't really know what you're doing with your body. Maybe you weren't told how to eat healthy, and you weren't told that oxygen is important for the functioning. I don't mean to laugh. Some of you might not have, but I'm saying like most people know that clean air is really important for healthy cell regeneration, or for your skin to be able to like grow new skin. Water intake, food intake, stretching, walking. These are all things that stimulate like healthy cell reproduction. Some of you are already working hard and have like this beautiful physique, and you're just looking in the mirror and you're just you're so appreciative of the body that you've been able to mold. And for others of you, you're going to be working toward this because you deserve to feel like that. I see you having new thoughts, newer healthy body, feeling like you're actually here on earth with this beautiful healthy body, and you're getting little psychic pings on little explosions, little potentials. You get just this little oh, maybe if I did this differently, maybe if I avoided this food. Your priorities changing. Then I'm going to have, when I look in the mirror, I'm just going to see this beautiful, radiant, glowing person, because that is who you deserve to be. Show me the Ace of Pentacles. Wow. You're going to feel like your body and your soul and your mind were all married and all in unison, working with one another. Alchemy. Surrendering to the fact that your body is probably the most important thing that you will own on this earth. People spend so much money on their vehicles. They spend so much money on these things that are not as important. Your body. Now that's something that's worth investing in. So how could you do that? Maybe buy something that you wouldn't ordinarily buy. Okay. Ace of Pentacles or Ace of Swords, please, Spirit. Okay, so I see you grappling, holding on to your old ways, even when these new pings come in from Spirit. It's you have this divine thought come down from Spirit into your brain, and you have this psychic awareness, but then. And you're yeah, I should do that. But then you walk away and you continue to hold on to your old strategy on how to keep going with your body, because it's all you knew until this moment. So it's almost holding on to the old is more comfortable for you. Let's see. So I'm getting a ping right now that for some of you, learning about your astrology sign might be exciting for you and helping the development of learning about your body. So I don't know them all, so I can't rattle them off. I know that Virgo is related to the intestine health. So if you're a Virgo, you could learn about what you could do for. So it's this: Virgos and the intestine go together. So if a Virgo wants to upgrade their health, they might look in how to make the intestine work better. And then you might run into the fact that probiotics are wonderful for the intestine. So you might want to learn about kombucha. Kombucha is a great healthy way to, if you Google kombucha, it'll show you what that can do for your intestine and healthy gut enzymes and keeping those in good order. So if you look up your sign, I'm a Leo, so Leo rules different things like the head, the neck, the heart. So I might want to look up heart health, and then I might find CoQ10 is really great for the heart, and so maybe I want to start taking supplements for that. I see the stars assisting you. The stars want to assist you. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. All right, I love that. Your cells are going to respond to this. It's not just going to be boring, mumble jumble crap. Your cells are going to open up and activate and be able to respond to your love, to your tender, loving care.
Okay, so some of you are drinking too much. Maybe it's just time to cut out alcohol. Alcohol sugars can be a lot. Maybe some of you like to go out and drink. Maybe some of you are drinking too many or drinking too many nights in a row, and the body cannot metabolize the amount of alcohols that you're putting into it. And just that alone is going to like tip the scales in your favor for these cells rebirthing themselves. Because for others of you, if you have like a health condition, I'm not saying that it's just going to immediately take your health condition away, but it might reverse fate a bit if you find an alternate way to love your body. Talking to your body, self-talk. Ace of Swords is all about communication. So, how are you speaking to yourself? I see body rebirth. I see new cells generating. I see circumstances changing. I see like different, like an ending of some sort of a conflict. Okay. Okay, so there's someone pouring out a drink that is not serving their body. So some of you are going to find out that a soda or some drink that you may be choosing isn't what's best for you. Or maybe you're going to find that cleaning your water properly is going to help bring forth this beautiful outlook on your body. Could be that you want to clean the heavy metals out of your water, and you're going to buy like some sort of filter that helps to do that. Moving forward, opposites attracting and opposites coming together in order to spring you into a forward motion. So if you just okay, so if you talk down on your body and you have like these things that you always go to in your head, maybe you say your eyes are ugly or your neck is ugly or your feet are ugly, I don't know, your hair, whatever it is that you look down upon, you have the capability to start nurturing and loving. And instead of pointing to that thing and degrading it, I see you like letting that thing guide you into ultimate like incentive and motivation, and having this becoming like an opportunity to benefit you and to bring you luck. Maybe some of you have had like troubling times with headaches. Maybe you'll find the reasoning, the pinpointing, the underlying reason. You'll have like a revelation. Oh, this person is not good for me. They give me headaches when I'm near them. Or maybe you're gonna find out that a certain product that you're using is not the best for you. And when you pull that out, it just helps you to feel more motivated, more ready to look at yourself in such a beautiful like opening. I see like this beautiful new opening being sourced from you loving your body. This is the blessing that I see coming for you. You matter to this world. You matter more than you realize, and it's time for you to like exchange whatever things that demeaned you and start generating it into a new avenue to uplift, encourage, regenerate. So I do not see a stalemate with your body, no matter what you're going through with your body. I see you purging something, releasing it, and finding some sort of a new balance that brings forth like an ending of some sort of conflict. It's very encouraging. It's very sweet. And I send you so much love as you continue moving toward this beautiful blessing that's awaiting you. All right, let's grab another card. All right. Wanting more for others puts me into an energy of abundance. Okay, beautiful. So when you look down on other people that seem to have a beautiful body, that's not going to help your body to feel happy or stable or comfortable. It's going to do the opposite. So looking, I'm not saying like, Spirit wants you to stop comparing. That's what I'm feeling from that. Okay, so wanting more for others puts me into an energy of abundance. So when you want others to be happy, because we all deserve to be happy, we all deserve to be beautiful, we all deserve to be abundant. And when you put yourself into that category, as we all deserve that, then beautiful things happen. Changes occur. Cells evolve. Cells move. Cells open. Cells exchange positive energy, because the water thing. What, I don't know if you've ever watched the videos on how water changes. So if you have it sitting next to someone that is miserable, then the water cells get all jaggedy and like sharp and squared. But if you have it next to someone that's like in a state of love and bliss, then the water is like creates these beautiful patterns that are like circular lined, beautiful. So, you know, that's the same goes to our body. Our body's made up of 70% water, right? So the same thing can be applied. So if we're hating on other people, that's the energy of hate, fear. It's going to make ourselves jaggedy and not in a flow state. If we love the beautiful people around us, or we love the beautiful attributes of the people around us, it's going to help ourselves go into a state of flow, harmony, stimulation, ceremony, like beautiful converging of cells together and creating like beautiful patterns. All right. So a lot of content in that reading. And I just like, you guys are gorgeous, and you have this beautiful, magical blessing awaiting you, of feeling gorgeous. And I just am so excited for you. And I send you so much love as you continue to detoxify whatever it is that may hold you back, because that is what you're doing, my friend. And I am so happy for you. Okay, so with that said, if this reading made sense to you, please leave me a like. Please subscribe to my channel. And if you can, leave me a little comment. All of that helps me to bring forth more of these readings and to conjoin myself into your energy. And also, if you're able to give a monetary donation to me at this time, something to help me keep this channel going, this would be of great help to me and my family at this time. We have a link at the bottom for PayPal, if that's something that is that would make your heart happy. Okay, so I hope to see you in the next reading. Until next time, everyone, take care.